After saving his friends from the mouth of Agasura, Lord Krishna brought them near the Yamuna River and said,
"My dear friends, this is a nice place to eat lunch and play on the soft sandy beach. Just see the sweet-smelling lotus flowers floating in the water. Just listen to the chirping birds and peacocks and the whispering of the leaves in the trees. Let us have our lunch right here. It is already late and we are also hungry. The calves can stay nearby to drink water from the river and eat the soft grass here."
Sitting down on the ground, they began to open their lunch boxes. Lord Sri Krishna sat down and all the boys sat around him in a circle. In his left hand, he held a lump of food made with yogurt, butter, rice, and pieces of fruit salad. He was laughing and joking, enjoying lunch with his friends in Vrindavan. In the sky, the demigods watched the boys while flying in their airplanes. Lord Brahma was especially enjoying what he saw. Meanwhile, the calves had walked too deep into the forest. The boys became afraid that their calves were lost, so they cried out, "Krishna! Krishna!" Just by calling out Krishna, at once they felt safe from any danger. Krishna said,
"My dear friends, please don't worry. Sit right here. I will look for the calves myself while you eat your lunch."
Somehow Lord Brahma stole all the calves and cowherd boys and took them to another place where they slept. Though Lord Krishna looked for them everywhere, he still could not find them at all. But he knew that Lord Brahma had taken all the boys and calves. Krishna thought,
"How can I go back alone to Vrindavan? Their mothers will be so sad and worried if they know their boys are lost."
So Krishna made himself into exact copies of each and every boy and calf. They were just like each and every one of the lost calves and friends in their different sizes, colors, faces, clothes, ornaments, and in whatever they said and whatever they did. When Krishna went back to the village of Vrindavan, no one knew what had happened. All the calves went to their cowsheds, and the boys went to their own mothers and homes. The mothers bathed their children, put on tilak and ornaments, and gave them their dinner after the day's work as usual. The calves came to their mother cows, who licked their bodies. Actually, the cows' love for their calves and the gopis' love for their boys grew even more, just like their love for Krishna. One day, Krishna and Balaram went out with the boys and calves. They saw the cows up on top of Govardhan Hill run down to their calves with tails up and full milk bags pouring milk on the ground out of love for their calves. The men up on the top of the hill could not stop them and had to chase them. When they came all the way down and saw their children, they picked them up in their arms very happily. After that, they went back up to the top of Govardhan Hill with their runaway cows. Along the way, they thought of their children with tears of love in their eyes. Balaram saw this and thought, "This must be Krishna's trick." Balaram understood that all those boys and calves were only forms expanded from Krishna. Balaram asked him,
"My dear Krishna, why did you turn yourself into these boys and calves? Where have those other boys and calves gone?" "They were all stolen by Lord Brahma the day when we had our picnic, so I made new cowherd boys and calves, so the people in Vrindavan would not know that they were really all lost."
While Krishna and Balaram were talking, Lord Brahma came back to see the fun made by his stealing the boys and calves. He saw them all there and thought,
"I just took all the boys and calves away from here, and I know they are still sleeping in another place. So how can the same boys and calves all be here playing with Krishna?"
Then Brahma saw something very wonderful happen. Krishna changed all those boys and calves into beautifully decorated four-armed Vishnu forms. And then he saw Krishna alone as a small cowherd boy, again with a lump of food in his left hand. All the Vishnu forms had gone, and Krishna was looking for his friends and calves, just as he was actually doing when they first disappeared. Lord Brahma got down from his great swan carrier and fell just like a golden stick to offer his respectful obeisances. All four helmets on Brahma's four heads touched Krishna's little lotus feet. As he remembered the wonderful sight he had seen, he cried happily and fell and rose again and again for a long time. Seeing the Lord right in front of him, he began to offer wonderful prayers. Lord Brahma said,
"Let me offer my obeisances unto the son of Maharaj Nanda, who is standing in front of me with conch shell, earrings, and a peacock feather on his head. His face is so beautiful, and he is wearing a helmet. Garlanded with forest flowers, he holds a piece of food in one hand and carries a stick, buffalo horn, and flute. He stands before me with small lotus feet. Oh, Krishna, you look just like a village boy, carrying your food in your hand and looking for your calves. First I saw you alone, then you made yourself into your friends, calves, and all of Vrindavan. Then I saw you and all the boys and calves as four-handed Vishnus, and they were being worshipped by all the demigods, even me. You are the Supreme Lord, the beginning of everything. Everything comes from you and again goes back to you, and you stay the same as before. Please accept me as your loving servant. I hope you will excuse me for disturbing you. Now please let me leave, so you can enjoy your friends and calves without me."
Lord Brahma walked around Krishna three times, offering his humble obeisances, and went back to his home called Brahma Loka. Then Krishna's friends, now on the bank of the Yamuna again, were eating lunch just as they were when Krishna left to look for the lost calves. When Krishna came, the boys said, "Please come and let us eat together." Krishna smiled and sat down.